My Gmail is full, and Google's threatening to stop my email. How do I make space? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I hear from time to time. A not enough storage after 20 days your Gmail will not work message appears. What should I do? You're approaching the amount of space allocated to your Google account. If you're running a free account, that's 15 gigabytes. It's possible you just have a lot of email saved online. That's common, and I'll show you one of the things you can do about that. But there are actually a couple of other possibilities as well. The storage you're allotted in Gmail is actually shared by at least three separate Google services. Gmail, the one you, of course, are aware of, Google Drive, and Google Photos. So the storage that they all use together, combined, is limited to 15 gigabytes. So I'll be using the free allotment here throughout for my example, since that's the most common situation people find themselves in. If you've purchased additional Google storage, you still have a limit. It's just more than 15 gigabytes. Near the bottom left of your gmail.com email interface, you'll see information about how much space you're currently using. So we'll go over here to my example Google account, and you can see down here at the bottom it says 12.5 gigabytes of 15 gigabytes are being used. Okay, I'm approaching, if you will, the limit of my account. If you click on that line of information, you might very well be taken to a page trying to sell you more storage. That's not really what we want. Instead, what I'm going to have you do is visit one.google.com/storage. I'm going to type it in here. So Google One is the brand name they use for their storage product, or Google Drive, or whatever online storage they want to provide. And then the storage page within Google One tells you what you've got, where it's being used. You've used 83% of your storage. Yeah, sure, they're still, again, trying to sell me more. But if we scroll down, we actually get an opportunity to see what's using all this space. And you can see that Gmail, in reality, is using very, very little. I've got almost nothing in Gmail. In fact, I have nothing in Google Photos. I'm not using Google Photos on this account. It's Google Drive that's taking up all the space. I have files in Google Drive that are taking up 12.5 gigabytes. Now, again, I need to be clear. No matter what's being stored or where it's being stored, once you hit that 15 gigabytes of space used, you're not going to be able to receive mail. You could have a completely empty Gmail, but if you've got 15 gigabytes of files in Google Drive, it's still going to come to a screeching halt. Now, Google Drive space is actually fairly easy to do. I'm going to do this from the web interface, but you can actually do this from the Google Drive desktop app as well. The bottom line is you either want to delete the files from your Google Drive folder or move the files that are currently in your Google Drive folder somewhere else. To do this online, I'm going to go ahead and go to my Google Drive here. And you can see that, sure enough, I've got this big old ISO file. In fact, I got a couple of ISO files sitting here in my Google Drive. That's what's taking up all that space. Each of them is like 6.25 gigabytes in size, and sure enough, they add up to that 12.5. Now, there are two things, like I said, I could do. One is, if I want to save this file, if I want to keep this file, I could right-click on it and just say download. That would allow me to download it to someplace on my computer, as long as that place is not within a Google Drive folder on my computer. That's great. You've got a copy of the file, and that copy is not going to take up additional space. Once you have the copy of the file, or once you are absolutely certain that you really don't need the file anymore, you can, of course, click on Move to Trash. I'm going to do that here because you'll notice that right away, nothing really changed about the amount of storage that I'm using. It's important to understand that when you delete something, it's simply being moved to trash and still taking up space. What you then need to do, if you're trying to free up space, is click on the trash folder online, and click on empty trash. You can see I've already got a few other things sitting here in trash that will end up going too. But the space that they're using is not freed up until you actually empty the trash. I'm going to do that. Again, you need to be absolutely certain that you no longer need these files, that it's okay for these files to go away forever. Once you do, then the space will be freed up. Now, the catch here, of course, is that it's still acting like it's not, right? In this case, it still says 12.51 of 15 gigabytes. It can take a little while. And in fact, you'll notice that while I was talking, it changed to 6.26. Give it time. Depending on how quickly things are going, it could take a few minutes for that number to get updated. Okay, what if it's not Google Drive? What if it's not Google Photos? What if you really are using up all that space in Gmail? Well, to begin with, in Gmail, which I've gone back to here, your inbox may be empty, but remember, you may have a lot of things in all mail. Those are things that are in your Gmail account, and they are all taking up space. You can, for those things that you actually don't want to keep or you're okay getting rid of forever, once again, you can right-click on them, click on delete, and that will remove them from all mail, but it will not remove them from the account until you go over to your trash folder and again, empty the trash. This is your final chance. Things that are in trash tend to get deleted eventually, but we're trying to do things right now, which is why we're taking that extra step of proactively emptying the trash folder. Now, that's for mail that you honestly never want to see again. Once you've deleted it from all mail and emptied your trash folder, that message, those emails are gone and they are not recoverable. One quick side note, by the way, spam also counts, right? The amount of spam that's in your spam folder also counts against your space. And of course, you can delete all your spam messages now to empty the spam folder. Same idea. Doing this has freed up the space that those messages were taking. But what if you've got email that you want to keep, but you don't want it to take up space in your Gmail account? What you end up doing, my suggested approach, is to fire up an email program on your desktop. Now, in my case, I have Thunderbird configured and ready to go. I have Thunderbird open on my Gmail account. This is Thunderbird configured to get email from that same account that we've been looking at online. And in fact, if we take a look at all mail, sure enough, there's everything that we saw in all mail. I'm going to put these two guys side by side so that we can see a little bit more closely what it is we're looking at. On the right-hand side, we have the online gmail.com representation of the email in my account. And on the left, we have the Thunderbird representation of that same account, email that has been downloaded to my PC. If you want to save email messages from your account, but you don't want them to take up space in your account, what you end up doing is creating yourself a folder within local folders. Local folders are folders that exist only on your PC. I'm going to right-click on it, and you can say new folder. Well, you can see I've already created an archived Gmail folder. If I now just select some random selection of messages from my all mail, and I drag and drop them onto archived Gmail, you can see that they've been removed from the all mail folder. They are now in the archived Gmail folder. And if I go back and I go back to the online version and refresh, the messages are removed from both places. So that's the thing to do. If you've got messages that you want to keep that are in your Gmail account, but they're taking up too much space, set up an email program like Thunderbird and move those messages from the folders they exist in online to local folders. Now, I've used Thunderbird as my example here. Many other email programs have the exact same concept. In Outlook, for example, Microsoft Office Outlook, you have the ability to create your own data file called a PST that you can then copy files into that remain local to your PC. The good news, of course, is that if those messages are local to your PC, they're also getting backed up when you back up your PC. So it's actually a really good way of ensuring that things are backed up. Now, I do have to include, for completeness, if you will, the fact that one solution, of course, that solves this problem almost instantly without doing a thing is to apply cache. In other words, buy some more Google space. I did some research not that long ago comparing Google space, Dropbox space, Microsoft space, and so forth. And Google One actually turns out to be one of the more cost-effective approaches for buying online cloud storage. So subscribing to one of their storage plans is another way to solve the problem without needing to do anything I've just discussed. I know that that's not for everyone. I'm not saying you should do this, but it is a potential solution for those that can. So, if you can, work to address this before it becomes a problem. Manage how much space you're using online. If you suddenly find yourself unable to receive email, you'll be in a bit of a panic to do something quickly to get it working again. If you can manage your usage between Google Mail, Google Drive, and Google Photos thriftily, you need never run into this dilemma at all. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177389. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.